Assalamu alaikum, my dear students. I hope you all are fine and paying good attention to your studies. My dear students, today's video is related to English, grade 2. As you all know that we have started our second term, today's video is related to Unit 11, Wise. My dear students, we have already completed the reading and explanation of this unit. My dear students, Wise is a poem written by Aline Fisher. In this poem, the poetess is appreciating the creations of Allah, who has created the huge and the small things so beautifully and perfect without any error. She is also thinking that how Allah got time to create all these things. There are different types of things which are described in this poem, but those things and all other things that we can see around ourselves are created by Allah. So now, my dear students, in this video, we will see the difficult words and their meaning. So let's start. My dear students, our question is, write meaning of the following words. Our first difficult word is wise. Wise. Its meaning is sensible, intelligent, sensible. Someone who is intelligent and who is able to take proper decisions. My dear students, our next difficult word is flakes. Flakes. Its meaning is a small piece broken from something. In detail, you can say a small or very thin layer or piece of something which is broken off from something larger, like the snowflakes. Snowflakes means small pieces of snow. My dear students, our next difficult word is spark. Its meaning is a small flash of light. For example, when we light up a matches or fire, it makes a spark. Sometimes that spark, that flash of light, is basically spark. Our next word is firefly. My dear students, it's a small insect. It's a flying insect with a tail that shines in the dark. This insects create shine, or you can say light, in the darkness. My dear students, now we will look at the questions given in the unit and their answers. Our first question is, who created the world? Its answer is very easy and pretty obvious. Allah created the world. My dear students, our next question is, what are the things in the poem which Allah has created? So we have to tell about the things which are mentioned in the poem. And the things which are mentioned by the poetess are land, sea, skies, sun, flowers, fireflies, and snowflakes. My dear students, our question number 3 is, what other creations of Allah can we see around us? Its answer is, we can see mountains, animals, plants, and all the things around us. So my dear students, these 3 questions are in the unit. First one is that who created the world? Allah has created the world. And the next 2 questions are about the creations of Allah. Now my dear students, we will solve a question given in the exercise. This question is given in Phonic Focus on book page number 62. It is about rhyming words. My dear students, we have already discussed this topic in detail, but let's revise it today. Rhyming words. Words with same ending sound are known as rhyming words. Like you can see, van, pan, hen, ten. So van and pan, they both are having same ending sound, n. And hen and ten, n. They both are having same ending sound. So rhyming words, the words that make same sound, the same musical rhythmic sound, they are known as rhyming words. They are so easy to find out. Mostly the poems have rhyming words in them. So This question is related to the rhyming words, the words of same ending sound. Our question given on book page number 62 is, find words from the poem that rhyme with the following. Make more rhyming words by yourself. As you all know that rhyming words make same ending sound, so let's start. Our first example is spark, shark. And the answer will be lark, park. Our next rhyming words are land, hand. And the answer will be and, band. My dear students, our next rhyming words are snow, glue. And the answers are flow, bow. My dear students, our next rhyming words are C, B. And the answer will be B, flea. Next rhyming words are small, all. And the answer will be fall, ball. So my dear students, rhyming words, the words that have same ending sounds. As you can see in all these examples written over here. Now, my dear students, we will solve another question given in the exercise. It is alphabetical order. As we have also read this topic in detail, so today we will just quickly revise that what is an alphabetical order. As it is written in front of you and it is clear from the word, from the name as well, alphabetical alphabets. So this is about alphabets, arranging the alphabets in order according to the order they are written. And what is that order? Just remember the order of A, B, C. First we have A, then B, then C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K. All these alphabets are coming in a sequence. After A, B will come. After B, C will come. It's not like that the D will come before C. It's not like that. They are in an order, in an organization, in a symmetry. So this order is known as alphabetical order, starting from A and it ends at Z. When we are given a question to arrange words according to the alphabetical order, we have to see that which alphabet are they starting with. We have to see the starting of those words. And then we have to arrange them according to the sequence of our ABC. Let's understand it with the help of these examples. Look at it in this picture. Here is a crab which is starting with C. So I have written just C over here. Next picture is elephant. E. It is starting with E. Next we have fish. It is starting with F. Then we have a bear, it is starting with B. Then we have a dog, which is starting with D. Now, my dear student, just memorize, just recall the ABC order. So, which word will come first of all? First of all, B will come. So, we will write bear. Then we will write down crab, C. Then we will write down dog. And then elephant and then fish. This is according to the ABC order. Now look at the next picture. Here we have apple starting with A, dog starting with D, fish with F, bird with B, egg with E, and O with owl. So the order will be A, B, C, D, E. A with apple, B with bird, then dog with D, then egg with E, then F with fish, and O with owl. All according to the ABCs. Now look at the next example. We have turkey, then we have corn, then gravy, then potatoes, then stuffing, then pie, and then cranberries, and then rolls. We will look at the starting of these words and then we will arrange them according to the alphabetical order. But did you notice something? That corn and cranberries are starting with C. Now what are we going to do over here? We don't need to worry, my dear students. When the first alphabet is similar, then we have to see the second alphabet. It is known as arranging the words according to the second alphabet. So over here we will see that corn, C-O, after C-O is coming. Now we will observe O, and in cranberry, R is coming. So in ABC, O comes before R, so we will write corn before writing cranberries. Now look, my dear students, there is no D in it, there is no E in it, there is no F in it. But here is a word gravy, which is starting with G. So then we will write down gravy. My dear students, after G, P comes according to the sequence, but there are two words with P. One is potatoes and one is pie. Once again, we will look at the second alphabet. In potatoes, we have O, and in pie, we have I. According to the alphabetical order, I will come before O. So first we will write pie, and then we will write down potatoes. My dear students, after P, R comes. Therefore, we will write down rolls. And after R, S comes, so we will write down stuffing, and in the end, we will write down turkey. So like this, we will follow the alphabetical order. My dear students, our today's question is, write the given words in alphabetical order according to the second letter of every word. As you have observed that when the first alphabet is similar, then we just follow the second one. Look at number one, it is wise, world, and way according to the second letter, and according to the alphabetical order, first we will write down way, then we will write down voice, and then we will write down world. Look at example number two, we have sea, sun, and sky. So its order, we will write down sea, sky, and sun. Example number three is thing, time, and two. This example is already written in the perfect order. So we will write it as it is. We will write down thing, time, and two. So my dear students, as you have noticed and understood that when words start with the same letters, they are arranged according to the second letter in alphabetical order. And it is very easy to find or to arrange words according to alphabetical order. Just memorize and recall your ABC and its sequence. My dear students, I hope you have understood all the topics mentioned in our today's video. Thank you so much.